Welcome to LoadRunner Tutorial 9. In this video, let us understand the user interface of the Run tab in Controller in detail. I have the scenario 1.lrs open that we created in the last video, and I have made a couple of changes. Instead of starting 15 Vusers, I have started 10 Vusers, and I have change the duration to 10 minutes. So now I'm going to start this scenario and it switches the run tab in the controller. Now in the run tab there are a number of panes. First we have the scenario groups pane. This shows the status of Vusers in the scenario groups. We have one group which is called the reservation group, and here we can see what is happening with the Vusers. Next, we have the scenario status pane. This shows the load test summary information like running Vusers, elapsed time, hits per second, past transactions, failed transactions, and so on. On the left hand side, we have the available graphs pane. Many graphs are available to drag to the display area. For example, maybe we want the throughput graph. So all we need to do is select it from the list of available graphs and drag it to the graph display pane, and now we get this graph also. Now this is the graph display pane. This shows between 1 and 8 graphs. So by default it shows 4 graphs. If you want to change it, we right click on it and go to view graphs and show 8 graphs. Now we can double click on any graph by first selecting it and then double click. This enlarges the graph to occupy the entire display area. If we double click on it once again, it is going to be reset. Now I'm going to close this by right clicking and click on close and view 4 graphs. Now if we select a particular graph, we can select a particular line in that graph. For example, this action transaction, and this is highlighted in the graph legends pane at the bottom. The graph's legends pane shows the data from the selected graph, and if we select a particular row from the graph legends pane, that is going to be highlighted in the graph. Now the scenario is already running and there is an important button for Vusers. This opens the Vusers dialog box. So I'm going to click on it and the Vusers dialog box is open. Here there are several options. We can stop any running Vuser. So for example, right now I've selected Vuser with ID of 5, which is an automatically generated ID, and click on gradual stop. Gradual stop means the controller will allow this Vuser to complete its current iteration and then stop it. There is another button for stop. This stops the Vuser immediately without allowing it to complete the current iteration. Now we can also add Vusers by clicking on the add Vusers button. So if I click on it, so let us say I want to add 5 more Vusers. So quantity to add is 5 and click on OK. So 5 more Vusers have been added. Now we can select one or more Vusers by selecting them, and we can run these Vusers. So I've clicked on run and these two Vusers are now initializing and then they will be in the run state. Now in order to see what a particular Vuser is doing at any time, we can use a show the selected Vusers button in the Vusers dialog box toolbar. So if I click here, it opens up two windows. So we have the reservation group 77 Vuser ID and reservation group 78 Vuser ID. And whatever these Vusers are doing at this time is shown in these windows. Now I'll close this. We can also see the Vuser log in case we have configured it in the runtime settings of the scenario. So let me select this Vuser and click on show Vuser log. So right now it is going to log only the error messages, but we can change this in the runtime setting and see the Vuser log for a particular Vuser. Now I'll close this Vusers dialog box. The scenario is still running and there are some errors. So if we want to see the errors or warnings or other notifications, we can see them in the output window. So click on View, Show Output. And here it shows us all the messages. So let us select just the errors. So there is an error which says CPU usage for this load generator has exceeded 80%. If we select it and click on details, it shows the details also in the text below. Close this output window. If the scenario is running, we can stop the scenario by clicking on the stop button. I'm going to stop this scenario now. Click on OK. Now this is about the user interface of the Run tab. Now if we see, it has already created the results in the configured results folder. And here we can go to results, results settings, and the results name and the directory in which it is going to be created can be configured here. If I start the scenario a second time, controller asks for the folder to save the files. So let me select it and it says results directory already exists. Do you want to overwrite it? Yes or no? We should click on no, because every time we run a particular scenario, we should save the results separately. So later on we can compare the results together. So I'm going to click on no. And the results name I'm going to put as results 2 and click on OK. So now we have two executions of this manual scenario and the controller will save the results to a different folder, because that is what we have just configured. So here we can see there is a result 1 and result 2. So that is about the user interface of the Run tab, and that is all in this video. See you in the next video. Thanks again.